Good morning and praise God. Welcome to our service today, Palm Sunday service, as we commemorate the triumphal entry of Jesus Christ in Jerusalem. As I've been encouraging you, brothers and sisters, the building is closed, but God's church is always open. I urge you to stay connected with one another through cell phone, social media, old-fashioned letter, and many other ways that you have to communicate with one another, to know how you are faring and how different families are faring. I want us to share the word of God from the book of Zechariah, chapter 2, verses 6 to 13. The Bible says, "Come, come, flee from the land of Nod, declares the Lord, for I have scattered you to the four winds of heaven, declares the Lord. Come, O Zion, escape, you who live in daughters of Babylon, for this is what the Lord Almighty says. After He has honored me and has sent me against the nations that have plundered you. For whoever touches you touches the apple of his eye. I will surely raise my hand against them, so that their slaves will be plundered them. Then you will know that the Lord Almighty has sent me. Shout and be glad, all daughters of Zion, for I am coming, and I will live among you, declares the Lord. Many nations will be joined with the Lord in that day and will become my people. I will live among you, and you will know that the Lord Almighty has sent me to you. The Lord will inherit Judah as his portion in the Holy Land and will again choose Jerusalem. Be still before the Lord, all mankind, because he has roused himself from his holy dwelling." And this is the word of the Lord. Let us pray. Our Lord and our God, it's our prayer that you may talk with each one of us as we share your word together. Encourage us, strengthen us, and warn us. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Brothers and sisters, as we commemorate this great day of triumphal entry of Jesus Christ to Jerusalem, and as we recall what Jesus Christ did at the time, Jesus Christ entered Jerusalem and the whole city was shaken. And all of them asked this question one to each other: Who is this man? And the crowd replied, "This is Jesus, the prophet from Nazareth in Galilee." As from Galilee. And as Jesus entered Jerusalem, just many of them, just 4 shouts before he would be arrested, he was received with great joy, jubilations, and the psalms and songs of joy. As he entered riding a donkey, the crowd spread their clothes, spread palm branches before him, and cried out, "Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest." That is Matthew chapter 21, verses 9. Now Jesus, he came to them as a king who humbled himself before them. Jesus was the King of kings and Lord of lords. And he was given this kind of welcome in Jerusalem to come and know more of securing the people whom he had. Now to us as Christians and believers, it has come a time when we all ought to go before him, surrender our difficulties. And more, it has come to a time when all of us have lost the hope. Some pray for the year 2020 to be reversed. Others pray that it may be swept away. We are in that dilemma as individual, as a church, and as a nation. One thing I know is that Christ lives, and as he entered Jerusalem with triumph and jubilation, the same it will be to our lives and to the lives of others. But I don't want us to lose hope. Let us remain in that and focused. My encouragement to you today is that Jehovah never abandons us. As Christ entered Jerusalem, may he wipe away all our tears, all our dilemmas, all our worries, and everything that makes us to lose hope in him. Now in Zechariah chapter 2, verses 6 to 13, Zechariah is calling to those who were scattered in the lands of exile to come and rebuild Jerusalem together in the light of what God prophesied and what God sent his prophecies to prophesy to the children of Israel. There comes a time in our lives when yet better come to grips with realization of some facts of life that we cannot afford to ignore. One fact is, coronavirus is a thorn on our flesh. And we all, as mankind and as human beings, together with the church and nation, are adamant of it. So that we are facing today, we are forgetting that God's plan for us, together with the nation and the church, and beyond what we are facing today. The current struggle, the current situation, the current matters that we are talking today of, they are facing today as today. But there is God who will wipe every tear, every worry, and every struggle, and give us life and it in abundance. Brothers and sisters, the future is a beautiful and a glorious one. God will establish his kingdom through you and I, through the church and the nation. We will never suffer beyond our faith. He will always stand for us to strengthen us. As Apostle Paul quoted in the book of Hebrews, how shall we escape this? If we neglect or we are ignorant of such great salvation that you have acquired through Jesus Christ the moment he was entering in Jerusalem. Someone asked me, where was God when the nation was shut down? Where was this God when I lost my job? Where is this Bible you are telling me it says when my family was suffering? Where was all these people, brothers and sisters? That is a show that we are losing hope and depending on what we know. God has not abandoned us. His covenant with us remained intact. God did not change anything. When you read Isaiah chapter 61, verses 1 and 2. The Bible says, and the Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is on me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good news to the poor. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim freedom for the captives and release from darkness the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn. This is God's assurance to us, and His plan remains that He will come to comfort us, to restore us, and to restore whatever we have lost in the hands of enemy. He came to us to deliver us from the bondage of coronavirus. He came to deliver us from bondage of sin, that we may not get lost, but remain in that before Him. God's assurance to us is that His plans to us remain intact. We will be free from the prison of COVID-19. Be comforted from all our distresses, and be comforted from all the stresses and dilemma. God is not hidden, neither is He silent. And if God is silent, in some of our own experiences, then it is because He has nothing to say. Either He has already spoken, therefore, nothing to hear. So we just need to recall what He has said. And that is, I am coming back again to restore, to rebuild you again, and to restore what you have lost in the hands of enemy. Therefore, brothers and sisters in the Lord, we ought to know that God loves us and guides us. He guards us that nothing whatsoever will fight against us. The Bible says in the book of Zechariah chapter 2 verse 8, He takes us as an apple of His eye. When you read Deuteronomy chapter 32 verses 20, the Bible says He shields him and cared for him. He guards him as the apple of His eye. He also cares for us, brothers and sisters. Nothing more that you ought to seek from different generation and cause, because He is faithful to us. His presence is our security. I urge you, my beloved brothers and sisters, return to God today. And if you are still wondering, come and have our safety in Jesus Christ. Listen to what God says, because that's the truth that He has for us. And it will come to pass, because it remains to be the truth to our lives. We have a living proof that Christ saves and that Christ fulfills His promises to us. The only word of God that we have is the word that gives life. It gives hope when we listen, when we believe upon it. The Bible says in Philippians chapter 2, verses 12 and 13, the Bible says, therefore, my dear friends, as you have always obeyed, not only in my presence, but now much more in my absence, continue to work out your salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God who works in you to will and to act according to His good purpose. This is to show that God promises to us, remains that I will come to deliver you from this bondage of suffering, of epidemic, COVID-19, that is a stress to us and the nation. Remember, our obedient act and the service to God today signifies eternal life to us and to our families. My brothers and sisters, I urge you today, stay at home, pray for one another, read the scripture, The moment you are washing your hands, put your hands together. Pray for the nation. Pray for the church. Pray for each one of us. For it's God's will for us to be the way we are. Let us pray. Dear God, we know that the first step in our life and in our spiritual healing is to believe. Therefore, Almighty God, we believe. We open our minds and hearts, believing in your infinity power and the possibilities. We believe that healing is a dynamic and a reachable experience, a reality that can be experienced right now and today. At a time as this, we maintain a patient and a loving attitude, for we believe that your healing activity is now at work in our minds and in our nation. We look forward with joyful expectations to the perfect wholeness that you are all now bringing into manifestations through our nation and through our people. We believe in your constant expression of perfect goodness in and through our nation. We rest in the certainty of your healing power and grace. We know that with you all things are possible. And as you enter in Jerusalem, the same you will enter in our country and bring a difference. This we pray in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Thank you, brothers and sisters. Have a blessed week, full of God's favor and grace. And for those who have not received Christ, try your best to seek where Christ is. If you really wish that you want to join the family of Christ and God, repeat this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I humble before your presence. A sinner, full of grief, I repent all my sins, and I pray that you may wash me with your blood. Write my name again in the book of life, and wrap it from all the books that have been written in, and deliver me from every snare of fall. In Jesus Christ's name, I pray. Amen. Shalom and blessed.